this is the greatest lesson for parents. No one really truly loves anyone. Everyone loves conditionally. Most love is conditioned, control-based, and fear-based. It's all about the self. So we live off prescriptive checklists and believe that if we don't follow that checklist, then we are somehow lesser than. And when we do this with a child who's come into this world with a throbbing spirit, desirous of kind of figuring it out, and we've kind of already ruined that chance by, you know, here's the checklist. This is what I believe is success and failure and beauty and achievement. And now follow my way or you're already an outcast in my eyes. This immediate placement of a way to be obscures the ability for the child to develop their way. And you will see most parents do not accept their children for who it is they are, because they're not good enough or great enough or fabulous enough or not some accolade enough, not a degree enough. And then I show parents that the reason they can't do this, accept their child unequivocally for who it is they are, is because they haven't accepted themselves for who it is they are. The main battle is my child is not who I thought my child would be. Either not a superstar soccer player or a fantastic pianist or obedient, genuflecting little servant, you know? Most parents who are raised on a diet of overachievement, on doing, have a very hard time understanding that their drive is not organic necessarily, but coming out of their inadequacy, their fear, their lack. They've just been indoctrinated to compensate for this, and they've never fully healed from their encountering their ordinariness. And so when I say that that's what's driving you, and then they get in touch with their little boy or little girl who truly felt ordinary and not good enough in that ordinariness, that's when the epiphany occurs. So then I make them see how it's now being projected onto the child. Don't do this to your child. Your child is okay and whole in their ordinariness. The child doesn't need more to feel more of themselves. They didn't come with this egoic desire to attach to PhDs or labels or judgments or wealth to feel themselves. Children feel themselves just by who it is they are. They have the simplest access to wholeness. We rob them of this. To truly love someone, it's truly loving the other for who it is they are, with no you in the picture. They don't have to love you back. They don't have to need you. They don't have to agree with you. They don't have to adhere to you. Now try loving your child for who it is they are.